So you've set up a YouTube ad campaign, you've turned it on, your ads are approved, but you're not getting any impressions. Your ads are not running. In this video, I'm going to talk about three things you can look for to figure out what's wrong and make sure that your ads start serving. My name is Kyle Sulerud, and my agency helps coaches and course creators and SaaS companies get more customers with YouTube ads. If you like this video and you want to see more videos about YouTube ads and Google ads, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Over the years, I've learned a few different reasons why an ad would be approved, but not getting any traffic on YouTube. So first and foremost, I want to make sure your ad is approved. So go into your ads section and make sure your ads say approved next to them. If not, then this video is not going to help you. You need to actually look at why the ad was disapproved. Google's going to tell you that. But if your ad is approved and you're still not getting any traffic, it can be harder to figure out. So the first thing I want you to look at is your bid strategy and the amount that you are bidding. It could be that you are just bidding too low and that's why Google's not sending you any traffic. If you're using a cost per view, a CPV bid strategy, and you're only bidding like 1 or 2 cents per view, then that might be why you're not getting any traffic. So what you can do to see if that's the reason is just to increase your bid. If you really want to figure it out quickly, increase the bid by a lot. Bid maybe 20 cents, 30 cents, or even 50 cents per view. If you're still not getting any traffic with a high bid like that, then it's probably something else. But if you start to get traffic, then you'll know that it's really just that you were bidding too low. If you're using a target CPA bid strategy, then maybe, again, you're bidding too low, or maybe it's just too early and Google's algorithms haven't really had a chance to start doing their work. In either case, what you can do here, again, is increase the bid. Maybe you increase the bid from $5 target CPA, like you're hoping to get, up to $30 or $50 target CPA. Now, as soon as you start getting traffic, you're going to want to start decreasing the target CPA again. You don't want that to be too high. But if you increase the target CPA bid and you start to get traffic, then you'll know, again, that was the reason. If you're bidding $50 as your target CPA, and even if it's a brand new campaign, if you're not getting any traffic, then you'll know that it must be something else. So let's move on to the second possible thing that could be happening. It could be that your targeting is too specific. So take a look at how you are targeting. There are different targeting options. We have placements and keywords and topics and audiences and demographics, right? Now, if you're using all of those options within the same ad group, it's going to layer them and it will be an and situation. So if you have a placement and a keyword and an audience, then the requirement would be that someone is watching that placement and they fit the requirement for the keyword and they are in the audience that you're targeting. That's a lot of criteria for someone to meet. So for this reason, I rarely layer the targeting. It just becomes too specific, and this might actually be why you're not getting any traffic to your campaign. The only time I would layer targeting would be with demographics on top of something else, but I wouldn't layer any of the other targeting options. So if that's the case, consider removing the layering and only targeting one type of thing. Only target placements or keywords or audiences. It could also be that you're just targeting too few placements or keywords. If you're only targeting 5 or 10 specific video placements, you might just not be getting any traffic to those videos right now. Or if you're only targeting a couple keywords, there might just not be traffic that Google's able to send you from those keywords. So make sure you're targeting a lot of stuff, a lot of placements, a lot of keywords. Otherwise, your targeting might just be too specific, and that's why your ads aren't showing. And the last thing to consider is, what are you saying in your ad? It's been happening a lot ever since the coronavirus pandemic started. Google has been getting very strict about what you can and can't say in your ad. But instead of disapproving ads, what's happening is they're somehow being flagged on the back end. And even though an ad might say approved in the ad account, there's something on the back end that's actually preventing the ad from running. So for example, if you say coronavirus in your ad, the ad's probably going to get approved, but then on the back end, the system is going to prevent that ad from running. So if that's possible, if you're saying anything in your ad that might have some kind of keyword that's being triggered like that, then just consider re-recording your ads and trying some different ads that don't talk about those specific words that could potentially be getting flagged by Google. Hopefully this video was helpful and it was one of those things and you were able to fix your ads and get them running. Leave a comment below and let me know what it was. If you still are not able to get your ads running, unfortunately I can't help anymore. I can't look at your campaign and tell you what's wrong. This is one of those rare times when you may just need to contact Google support and try to get someone there to help you out. Again, my name is Kyle Sulerud. Be sure to subscribe for more videos. And if you want more help with your YouTube ads, and especially if you have a webinar that you're using to sell your product or service, then reach out to me because that's what my agency specializes in. Our clients are coaches and SaaS companies and course creators who are using webinars to book calls or to sell their programs. So if that's you, click the link in the description of this video and go to my website and you can see more about what it would look like for me and my team to work with you. You wouldn't have to worry anymore about your ads approved and not running because we would be taking care of all that and of course a whole lot more. So if that's you, click the link in the description. And everyone else, make sure to subscribe if you want more videos about YouTube ads. And I'll see you in the next video.